Rebecca Schofstahl, DTI Academy Manager at DigitalThinker. I wanted to take a few minutes to share what I believe is one of the highlights of the HxGN EAM version 12.1 release, Approval Workflows. Previously, approval workflows have been controlled via status authorizations and even custom solutions using Flex business rules. Now, approval workflows can be established for work orders, case management records, requisitions, and purchase orders. Now, approval workflows will need to be set up by a system administrator on the approval workflow setup screen. Here, I have an example of the approval workflow setup for purchase orders. Now, there are three different types of approval flows: sequential, parallel all, and parallel any. This example follows the sequential type. You'll also notice that you can define the from and activation status. So this workflow will activate when the user changes the status from unfinished to awaiting approval. And below, you can also define the end of workflow record statuses. But let's take a quick look at the parameter definitions. Parameters can be defined to include record details in email notifications and control whether a workflow is activated. This would allow you to have separate workflows by organization, for example. If you take a look here, we have an activation condition based on organization. Now let's look at the approval steps. The first step in the sequence is to the default approver defined on the purchase order. Then we have a condition. If the PO is less than or equal to $10,000, the system will auto-approve it after the default approver approves the purchase order. If the PO is greater than $10,000, then we have it set up to go to an approval list or a list of approvers. Let's take a look at a purchase order that's currently under the approval workflow. This purchase order is currently awaiting approval, and you'll notice that the status field is protected. There is this blue icon that will show you that approval workflow is in progress. Now, as, let's say, a buyer, if I was curious as to where this purchase order is in the workflow approval process, I could reference the workflow approval tab. You'll see here that my default approver has already approved the PO, and it's currently pending review by another user. As someone responsible for reviewing and approving records, you could do so directly from the workflow approval tab on the purchase order screen, the requisition screen, the work order screen, or there is a new central screen called workflow approval. So you would need to add this screen to the appropriate user group menus, but it's a central location for your approvers to go in and view all of the items pending their review. So from here, I could quickly access the source record. In this case, it would be my purchase order. I could add comments. I could add documents. Then I could quickly either approve or reject the item. In this case, if I approve the purchase order, that will complete the workflow and my purchase order will update to approved. So So I appreciate you joining and following along as I kind of touched on approval workflows in version 12.1 of HxGN EAM. Please reach out to the Digital Thinker team. We can always work with you and guide you through implementing approval workflows. And this would just allow you to automate and streamline the approval process. Thanks for watching.